Transportation Administration in just a moment here. In the box, we have two of our Hurst rescue specialists, Tim Schott and Larry Anderson. And as you can see, we have a 2017 Model X from Tesla. Frankly, one of the coolest, most technologically advanced vehicles on the road today. And frankly, before we get into it, I want to point out that at Hurst, we pride ourselves on making extremely high-performance rescue tools. We want to deliver the speed and power you need to deal with today's rescue challenges. But at the end of the day, that's not the most important thing. The most important thing is that that tool is in the hands of a skilled rescuer with the training to execute that extrication swiftly and safely. And in the spirit of encouraging more frequent training at those fire departments as the auto industry changes, we've invited in an extremely knowledgeable rescue trainer to lead this demonstration to show how you can extricate on one of the toughest cars on the road, but do it quickly and safely. Without further ado, let me introduce Mr. Brock Archer, the owner of Advanced Extrication.
Vehicles, that are equipped with electric door latches on the outside. We have mechanical linkage on the inside. So as a rec viewer, what does that mean? To get that front door open, you can actually take the glass, reach inside, and use the handle on the inside in order to get that door open, to engage that. Notice the behavior of that metal. It looks different than what you're used to. That's because it's aluminum. And we're not talking about soft aluminum that bends easily. This is very, very high strength, real aluminum that actually cracks when we put force on it. So it's a very different type of finished construction than we're used to seeing. So they take that one more at the last, and now they can come up and take those two front pieces. The reason that we're using the color there on the edges is because gas is placed on the wire. So when gas is placed on the wire, one of the things that we typically do is try to preserve the integrity of that lower A pillar. And if you use the shredders up there, you'll often compromise the integrity of that lower A pillar. So we're preserving that by making it up rather than spread that door off. Changes that we see in most of our conventional construction. At this point, they're going to move back to the thousands and more. They're conscious at this point of the
Larry.
So they're located in the door.
Larry.
Just below the area he's looking. The idea here is to break this door.
Larry, watch your feet. Watch your feet.
And we've got the lower section of the door. Once we've separated the top section of the door from the lower section of the door, we want to maintain control of that top section of the door. And the reason for that is there's a high tension spring that actually drives that door up. And if we release it in an uncontrolled fashion, it might screw it up and it could injure a rescuer. So they're going to maintain control of that upper section of the door as they break this door in two pieces. We've found it to be effective to simply use the spreaders, again, in a modified version brush to break
like
that away.
Proxy, and last proxy, last proxy, last proxy, last proxy.
To come in with the butter and break it through the door seal.
Does Tim get nervous from this stuff at all? He's pretty confident.
And now with that door peeled a little bit, you can see that airbag in the door.
That's
the perfect airbag for Model X. Model X has a loose railing, like most of the vehicles. And so they place that perfect airbag in the door. And it actually supports part of the cover, but a side wall. Just going to make a couple of steps to clear that section of the door. And now we can do it at the bottom of the door, just like we would a conventional vehicle. Of course, there's a lot of options for getting this accomplished. This is one technique that we've found to be effective for this. But again, if you're interested, you're going to use your best judgment to evaluate the vehicle's construction, evaluate the rest, and make a decision based on what you're talking about. One latch on the Model X is called the door. There's one single latch at the bottom of that door in the center. At this point, the guys are going to prepare for their gas displacement effort. We're going to start off by using the first gas, but take a look at as the suspender comes on, how it doesn't behave like a typical construction. Again, we're dealing with aluminum, it tends to grow rather than rip and bend, like you see in a steel construction. With aluminum body structures, especially electric vehicles, where we don't have an internal combustion engine in the engine compartments, what we find is we have very unique structural and upper rail reinforcements. So when you have you want to make sure that you want to add that upper rail and that flexible seat, because your seat cut that you're going to need to make will be a little bit different than what you're used to. So it's important that we do a good evaluation of our structure. The guy that's pulling the fender off,
the way so when they can get to the truck, they can come in the hood area.
The lower apron in fact is breaking packs. It's bent before it fractures.
Yeah.
Notice it didn't look over.
Larry, for you to ship that V-post to me.